Well, let's look at how to create planes. So this is part one, new part. So the first thing you have to do, you go to features, go to reference geometry, and click this drop down, select plane. By default, there are three references you can use. In this case, I'll show an example using one reference. Okay, after choosing your first reference, you modify the distance between that reference and the new plane you intend to create. You can change the direction by flipping offset. You can as well increase the number of planes you want. Yeah. So let's say you're satisfied with that and you've created your three planes. Planes are usually created in Solidworks to enable you have a better advantage when you're sketching, in case you don't want to use the three default planes of front, top, and right. And when you're sketching the planes and you finish your sketch and you want to look at your model clearly enough, you can come to this icon, which is for controlling the visibility, and you can hide all the planes in the scene. So that is when you're using one reference. Sometimes you might want the plane to be created at an angle. Let's say, for example, I go to right plane sketch. So there you have to come up with your reference, assuming you wanted the plane to be at this angle, just like this line I've drawn. So you have to draw a reference. You can either draw a full line or you can use a construction line. Okay, so let's go to features, reference geometry, select plane. First reference, select the right plane. Second reference, pick that line, and then your plane will come to that orientation of your choice. Yeah, let's see an example where I created planes to achieve complex sketches or maybe orientation. So I'll first go with this one, front plane, and I think was created using the front plane. Yes, so the front plane was the reference, and then this is the distance of separation, and I had to flip the offset. So this is the front plane here, and then the plane I created, which is plane 2. And an example whereby I had a slanting orientation is plane 8. Let's see. So in plane 8, I had to draw a line to be used as the first reference. So I drew the line, then at the point, this end point is the second reference. Then the plane appeared after that. You can see from this hierarchy where plane 8 appears. So after that, I used plane 8 to enable me sketch this part, which is sketch 32. Yeah, see, it was sketched on plane 8, and I think it's like a suspension strut, more like a cylinder for this wheel to be supported on. Yeah, so you need to know how to create planes and use planes. For a beginner, once you've created a plane, whether it is perpendicular or at an angle, just use those tricks I've demonstrated. You draw a reference line and and then pick the right orientation you want. Like this case, I wanted it at this angle so that I could draw this and extrude it. So I'll look at how to extrude, how to apply this fillet in the next chapter. Yeah, so you can do away with creating planes when you're coming up with complex geometry. Even sometimes simple geometry, you will need planes. So the basic thing is, once you go to features, select reference geometry, go to plane, and then pick the references. Third reference can be when you want something to really be well defined, but you can do it first and second, and you create your plane. Yes. Thank you.